So question number 16, let's continue.
Okay.
So here, fancy bed and breakfast wing has 5 rooms, correct? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So this.
It's just 120. 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 and 1s. Right?
No, no, no. Can you calculate it again, please?
Okay.
One day, my friends are arriving. So each room, see, for this, you can make it out like this. Like each room will have one guest, okay? So in that case, what will happen? We have 5 guests to choose from the first room, okay? So for the second room, so totally it will be 5 factorial, so 120, okay?
This yes, is for the first this
room. Is. Okay. Oh. So this is for the first case, okay?
This is for the first case.
3 cases, because you will be having, they are saying in total you have to see, okay? 3 cases I will have. One first cases,
okay.
Each room houses one guest. Okay. Second case, 2 rooms houses 2 guests.
No, okay? But look, but with no more than 2 friends per room.
No, no, and we have to calculate in how many ways can the innkeeper assign the guest to the room. So we have to see all the possible ways, and then we okay. have to see. Okay. Otherwise, directly if we are going to do, this is the only possible way we can get. Yeah. 1 second. No, mm-hmm. we have to go by this only. See, each room, first case, I will take it to be each room will have 1 guest. Okay. So we have 5 guests to choose for the first room, 4 for the second one. So totally it is like 5 factorial, as you told, 120. Next case 2, I will take 3 rooms. I will take. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
3 rooms, 1 guest. Okay. So, 1 houses, it will be 2 people, correct? So, totally 5, I have 3 ways to choose. Okay?
I don't understand, like, what? Don't you need 1 per each room?
Or otherwise... Okay, let me think of another way. Just give me a quick second.
It says no more than 2 friends per room.
Yeah, yeah. We have to think it and see. Here we can work it in reverse order and see. Determine how many number of combinations in which more than 2 friends can be at least in one room. So I will do it like this. See, I will do it on the whiteboard. Instead of calculating here, I will do this on the whiteboard and show. The paper instead of the doing here, I will do it on the whiteboard. Okay, see what I'm saying. First case 1, I will take to be 3 friends are in one room. Okay, So there are 5 possible rooms in which you this will occur, correct? So, and we are choosing 3 friends from the 5, and the other 2 friends each can each be in another 4 rooms. Remaining rooms. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Okay. So how can you write that? It is 5 times 5C3 times 4 times 2. Correct? 3 friends are there in one room. So 5 possible rooms in which this will be occurring. So 5 possible. So 5C3. We are choosing 3 friends from the 5. Correct? And the other 2 friends can be in any of the 4 remaining. Okay? Any of the 4 remain. So if I do this, 1 minute. Let's see. 800 I'm getting. 800 possibilities are there. Case 2, I will take 4 friends are in one particular room. Okay. You should choose all the possibilities and then you have to give a common answer. Okay. Right?
Okay.
4 friends are in one room. Again, there will be five possible rooms for you, and you are going to choose four of the five. Correct? Yes. Yeah. So in that five will be there, and you are going to have 5C4. Okay? Because there are five possible rooms, you are going to choose four of the five. And another one can be any of the four rooms. So that.
Yeah.
Okay. So that if I can take it. And okay. Let's go to the third case. Okay. If I go to the third case, five friends are going to be in one room. Okay. Fine. So if that is the case, means if there are five possible rooms in which they can have, correct? So it is 5 to the power of 5. Yes, oh.
Mm-hmm.
5 to the power of 5 will be getting 3,125 possible combinations. What I'm saying, the question is, you need to calculate your how many ways in your which the innkeeper can assign the guest to the rooms, correct? Okay. So only one person. So in that case, it would be from the total, I'm asking you to subtract this 800 plus what is the case 2 we have got? This 100 plus the 5, whatever is it. If you do, you will get your answer next. You got my point?
Yeah. But I got confused because it says they cannot house more than 2 friends per room.
We are just discussing all the possibilities. If you are having a rectangle or something, or the inner shaded part alone, you have to find what you will do. You will find the outer portion and subtract it through. That's what I'm doing. From the outer one, I'm doing all the possibilities and then subtracting from the total also, you can get it out. If all of them are there in the one particular room, when you subtract it from the each possibilities, then you will get the same.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 1 minute. Let me calculate my... 3, 1, 2, 5. So 2,220 I'm getting. Okay.
Okay.
So n number of ways of solving the problems. The thing is, we need to select our way. Okay.
Okay.
Five. It's 1. Okay. What about the third one? Sorry, 17. So it's asked in AMC 10. Okay. 3 distinct vertices of a cube are chosen at random. What is the probability that the plane determined by these 3 vertices contains points inside the cube? Okay.
It's 8 choose 3, right?
Pardon?
It's 8 choose 3, 56.
You are saying the answer?
Yes.
Just
8 choose 3, right? Okay.
No, no, no. 1 minute, 1 minute, I'm just calculating, just give me a second. Probability?
Oh, probability, okay.
We have to calculate the probability.
I don't understand the problem.
The distinct vertices of a cube we are going to take, okay? You know how many sides are there, the sides, 6 sides are there in a cube, right?
Mm-hmm.
You are going to take any 3 distinct vertices, okay? What is the probability that the plane determined by these 3 vertices contains points inside the cube? So, first of all, you have to take the number of planes determined by any of the 3 vertices of the cube, okay? So, in a cube, what all the things will be there? You will be having 6 surface, 1 minute. You will be having 6 surfaces, 6 opposing parallel edges, 8 points. Okay. that will be cut by your fifth. So totally 20 will be there, correct?
Yes.
Any so number of planes determined by any of the three vertices of the cube will be 20. Among your 20 planes, only 6 surfaces will not cut into the cube, correct?
What?
I'm saying among the 20 planes, 6 will not cut into a cube. If you are not in the trouble surface, let me think of another way. How many vertices will be there in a cube? 8, right? Yeah, 8 vertices yes. will be there. You have to select 3 from that. We can do it like this. 8 vertices will be there. You need to select 3 from that. 8C3, 1 minute. 56. So, there are 56 ways to pick 3 vertices from 8 total vertices.
Yes.
So, this will be our denominator. Now, we have to select 3 points inside the cube so that they cannot be on the surface. That's the condition given in the question. Okay. So, then I will say that how many ways? 4 ways you can choose 3 points from the vertices of a single face. Correct? You just think of a single face. Okay. How many ways vertices will be there? You have 4 possibilities. Yes?
Yes.
So it is you have 4C3 ways of selecting 3 points from the vertices of a single face. Okay?
Now, times 6.
Yes, because totally 6 faces are there. So it is 4 times 6, which is 24.
24.
Okay? So
yes.
Totally I got here 56. So 24 divided by 56. That you can say just 3 upon 7. Okay, this is the probability of what we don't want is. Correct?
Why?
This is, we doesn't want, right? This one we doesn't want to know.
See, I don't here, want to. Okay.
I'm just calculating, see, read the question. What is the probability that the plane determined by these 3 vertices contains points? This is the one we doesn't want. So you subtract it from 1, you will get the answer for the
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So that would be for 7 minus 3, 4 upon 7 will be the probability. Okay.
Got Can it? You say, okay.
Will I explain it again?
No, I'm good.
Oh. Next question.
Okay. Is
that one slice left
You got the answer? No.
No.
What?
Don't understand, like, what's the probability that he picks a 9?
Yeah, you take it as two cases. He picks 9,
yes, but
he doesn't pick 9, like that.
Then, so it's
you
like,
can just, then you can add up the two cases and get that.
9 choose 3, and then out of that, he doesn't want. So, he doesn't want.
See, when he picks 9, if he picks a 9, then it is guaranteed that his number will be a larger than 2
yes.
correct? So, probability of picking a 9 will be 1 times 8C2 divided by
9C2. Was it, why 8 over 2?
I'm not saying 8 over 2. I'm saying 8C2.
Yeah, but like, why 8C2?
Because, see, here they have said 2 chances are there will be for him, right?
Mm-hmm.
From the 8.
Yes. Good, 8 and you choose 2.
Otherwise, we can do like this. Totally, there will be 9C3 ways, correct? You can randomly choose this.
Yeah.
So, 9C3 means it could be 84, correct? 84 numbers that you can choose it. And for Sylvia set, 8C3, correct? 56.
Yes.
So when I multiply this pairs of number, you can compare it. For example, if suppose Sylvia is going to choose 321 and 543, there is one pair, okay? So in that case, okay, I will explain this in the next class.
Okay.
I will just see to that. Some other thing should come here.
Okay.
Because for AMC, we are taking like this a very lengthy method also. That is also not good. I'll just see to that. Okay. I'll just solve this. I will send the answers to you, but class, I will just explain it again. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah. Okay then. Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
So I will catch you Friday class. Sorry, Friday evening class. Please let me know. Okay, if you are free or something, if you're free, we can have it at 7:30. Otherwise, I will catch you on Sunday. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.